What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about the Whitcomb area rule. We'll be going through the cross-sectional area and how that factors in, as well as something called wasting. So let's talk about the area rule to begin with, and this shouldn't be confused with something called the supersonic area rule, which is more to do with the nose of an airplane and how straight it is, or like angled it is, and it changes the angle of the Mach cone coming out, the shockwaves. This is more for transonic flow, so when we're approaching sonic speeds. So what is the Whitcomb area rule? Well, first of all, let's say we have an airplane and we're looking down on it, and we're just gonna have a fairly simplified airplane where we have the nose coming in like this, then we have the fuselage, and then we have the wings coming up. And then let's just cut it off quite straight at the back. So it's almost like a delta wing. And if we were to plot the cross-sectional area as we go along from the nose to the tail, we'll see that it will start to increase a little bit, and then at certain points it will jump up and then go a little more constant and then jump up again. And the point at which this line jumps up, the more discontinuous it is, or the sharper this slope is, the greater the wave drag will be of this object when we start to approach Mach equals one, sonic speeds. So if you don't know what wave drag is, that is when you have an object going quite fast. The faster you go, the less chance or less ability the air has to move out of the way of the object. And once you start moving to sonic speeds, the air can't really move away fast enough. So you have this object coming through and it just keeps pushing these air molecules together, and they start to compress together and they can't move. So there's a very high pressure there, and that's the shockwave starting to form. That then results in wave drag occurring, and as we lead up to that shockwave. And these discontinuities increase that wave drag. Now this, back in 1955 and even earlier in other areas of aerodynamics, such as ballistics, they looked at the cross-sectional area of this thing, and they found that the more continuous and the flatter this line is, so we get rid of these bumps, the less the wave drag is. So this object can actually travel faster and also incur less drag when we have a fairly continuously changing cross-sectional area, as opposed to having these bumps here and discontinuities even. For example, if we have intakes here, so we then put intakes here for the engine, we have some thickness here, and that will start to increase the cross-sectional area a little bit discontinuously. So to get around that, we have to make sure that whatever we put on this object, the cross-sectional area doesn't really fan out too quickly. So if we have these wings, we can then make them a little bit narrower. Alternatively, we may not have that opportunity, because we may need to have the wings a certain size, and we need to have the object not like a million meters long, it can only be a certain length. So we're kind of restricted there, and that results in something called wasting. And this is a very common way of reducing the drag of an airplane or object as we approach transonic speeds. So if we have this object here, where the fuselage stays one constant width, diameter as we go along, we can actually now design this airplane so that we start to reduce the cross-sectional area. So this is called wasting. And another term is necking as well. So when you neck something down. So if we have the exact same airplane, we have the nose, and then it comes into the fuselage. I've drawn it a little bit wonky here, but let's just assume it's the same. And then we get to the wings. So we have the exact same wing, but now when the wings start, we actually start to bring this fuselage in. And the amount we bring the fuselage in is the exact opposite amount of the area that these wings introduce. So if we take this cross-sectional area here compared to this cross-sectional area here, if the fuselage has a cross-sectional area of, let's say, 0.1 meters squared or whatever it is, this can be a model, it can be anything, let's say 0.1 meters squared, and then this entire path here hopefully will be about 0.1 meters squared as well, so that we don't have a significant change in the cross-sectional area, so we can reduce the drag. So if the wings themselves take up 0.05 square meters, this fuselage has to be necked down to 0.05 meters squared as well. So we have that 0.1 meter squared total. That way we can reduce the drag of this object. And as I mentioned, this is often called the Whitcomb area rule, but also sometimes referred to as just the area rule. And by doing this, generally speaking, the wave or the drag in total of this airplane is about halved on average. So if we were to have this airplane would have about twice as much drag as this, with this Whitcomb area rule being followed and this wasting process. So that is this video. If you liked it, make sure to like and click the subscribe button. And I'll see you soon. Peace, amigos.